to pick.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Best of Five Grand Final.
You sound like an airline pilot.
An airline pilot? What do you mean?
Yeah, you know how like good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this another episode of Dota 2, which is giving you more versus E-Home. We're going to be bringing you back into a fourth game in a Best of Five series. We'd like to make sure you keep your flight attendants in their upright and locked position during the duration of the flight, and make sure you ban Drill Ranger. Oh, look, they did.
So we know you've probably seen this safety explanation before, but we do ask that you do watch it once more, as some of you.
I can't handle this, dude.
Absolutely. E-Home versus VG Game Reborn. We're here. I'm going to pick Tom Amy Draskell, and the draft is in. As you said, Drill has been banned. Terrorblade has been banned. E-Home, they picked Voiceless Void first. Again, you know, this series fails to impress. Mm-hmm. No, it doesn't fail to impress.
Yeah, I mean, the draw is two for two, right?
Yeah. Void picked up. This is different. This is good.
Yeah.
Versus Void.
No, I mean, Void was obviously banned in the first two last game. I think it was Evil themselves who actually took it out. So a couple of other heroes we haven't had a chance to see in the series making their way through the DP and the Faceless Void. We have seen Bat. We have seen Disruptor. Actually, no, wait. Was Bat picked in the series? Maybe I'm thinking of the previous series.
I want to say we haven't seen a Bat Rider.
No. Not in the last series it was. In this series it was not.
Yes.
So they're going to take out the Lanham Kunkka. A little bit of a respect ban there. Very strong rotating hero that E-Home have been showing throughout the entirety of the Chinese qualifiers. I am a big fan of that ban. But 5 seconds remaining. Isn't it usually just an offlane Void from E-Home? I want to say that it's old 11 almost exclusively who plays this hero.
I want to agree with that, yeah. It certainly strikes me as an old 11 hero rather than a nice ice carry hero, for sure. And I think when you pick it up first as well, that's probably more likely to be your offlaner than your safe lane carry, yeah.
Well, I mean, obviously there's some flexibility.
I guess there is, yeah.
Set in
absolutely,
stone.
Absolutely. I mean, the way that E-Home have been playing, I won't be surprised if old Lanham picks it up, grabs an Iron Talon and goes jungle. Actually, that was old 11, sorry, wasn't it?
Yeah, old 11.
I mean, he... Jungle Void, is that a thing? Old Lem will probably
make it.
Definitely
is.
Yeah.
I think actually Jungle Void is more of a thing than actually going like to lane if you're going to be in the offlane position most of the time.
I mean, Old Lem, he's definitely been, going jungle every time. What, Tusk? Axe? Can't remember what he played in the other game, but he was probably in the jungle.
Most likely.
Kunkka ban, Elder Titan ban, absolutely necessary against E-Home. We know how good they are with the Lanham Kunkka, so you don't want to give them a chance of doing that. Elder Titan as well. He's up there, with, in my opinion, with the Terrorblade as kind of the heroes at the moment. Heroes you just don't want to deal with. 10 seconds not at all. Remaining. No, thank you. Goodbye. Io is going to get through again for Avicii Reborn, and they're going to be happy with that one. I mean, this is a hero that does get overlooked because of all the other strong heroes in the current meta. But FYI, it was certainly pretty... pretty damn ridiculous in that last game.
It was very legit.
Yeah.
He had some actually super fast reaction time saves. Like normally you kind of wait a second or two before you start channeling the relocate, but it's like FY knew exactly who they were going on before I think even E-Home knew who they were going on. And then they just get him out of the static storm in the last game or, you know, any initiation potential that was going to be coming up from E-Home, he just completely stopped from those reloads. So
it was
very
nice.
Impressive stuff. That does mean they have both of their supports, though, so no Vengeful Spirit for the save or anything like that. E-Home going for a lineup that very, very heavy physical DPS here.
And it's the classic kind of... I mean, Klink's picked up against Io. That's what a lot of teams like to go, isn't it?
Yeah, you kill the Wisp super fast.
Yeah. Oh, Lycan getting through the draft here for Vici Reborn. They can't get themselves the Drow, so Lycan... It's a kind of an alternative to the Drow Ranger. You got the bonus for the damage for your team, and you're going to be able to push down towers.
The other thing about Lycan is that, you know, Klinks is a hero who, inside of a team fight, kind of wants to sit there and just auto attack people. But if Lycan's running at you,
you got
to
run.
You cannot sit there. You have to bail. So not really much control outside of the Chronosphere right now for the Lycan. Beastmaster, interestingly enough, has made his way all the way to this point in the pool, which I think is ridiculous. I think E-Home probably a bit more likely to pick it up than Vici, but they could both technically field it. You know, Mikasa Bat has been a thing. I think that Beast is really good for both teams.
Oh, I like that as well. That's, I mean, you said, you know, Klinks, he needs to sit there and deal the damage without worrying about dying. Oracle's going to be able to help with that.
Yeah, you can disarm the Lycan. That's the biggest thing. Since he's the only right-clicker on Vici, it's nice to be able to just use Fate's Edict and say, yeah, okay, you're not attacking for like 5 or 6 seconds.
And it's so good. It's obviously very good against the Batrider, and also very nice with the Death Prophet as well. It is a great pick here, I feel, for E-Home. We could be in for quite a treat in terms of Oracle gameplay.
It's actually an even better pick, because you could still end your lineup with Beastmaster. And having Oracle means that, you know, Vici Gaming, if they wanted to pick Beast, E-Home had the first pick out of the ban phase, so they can just take it away from them if they want to go that route. It's just interesting to me how people have went from very heavily favoring Beastmaster, like first, second ban, to we're banning Terrorblade, we're banning Drow, Lifestealer, and Naga instead. Like the bans and picks have just kind of evolved throughout the qualifiers, as they normally do. You know, it's a meta thing that kind of develops per tournament. But this time around, we're seeing two new heroes in the series. Actually, five new heroes? Yeah, Oracle, Void. Clings, Death Prophet, Bat, and Lycan. Oh, and Void.
That's six.
That's six, yeah. So it's almost like an entirely new lineup.
It has been a good finals, yeah. We are seeing back and forth games. You know, some of them stomps, but they're fun, you know, fun stomps and beatdowns to watch. And it's good that they're happening, you know, both ways around. You know, both teams showing us that they have what it takes to take the series. And, well, Axe is going to be the final ban.
It's a good ban. It's very good against Lycan.
Okay.
It gives you kind of that opening inside of the team fight. It's AoE control. They only have one real save this game on the aisle, and both of their supports have already been picked. So it's not like last game where you have a swap and a relocate.
Yeah.
You only really have one. So Axe brings... Well, he brings the Axe.
And I guess, arguably, Axe was probably the hero giving them the most difficulties last game. Even though they still win, obviously the Axe was annoying. Storm Spirit ban. Now, that does strike me as interesting. I mean, do you think there was a chance they would be picking up a Storm this game?
They have been picking it a lot. I mean, they picked it two games this series.
It's something that they do value very, very highly.
It gives them great initiation. And yes. I think that EHOME were scared of Vici picking up a hero that could just jump on the back line. Yes. Like, finding the Oracle or finding the Faceless Void before they're able to get their ultimates off can be pretty devastating in fights. And then you have two-pronged initiation. You have the Batrider, and then you have the Storm. Plus, there's a relocate to follow it up. So I think that in of itself maybe pressures the map a little bit too much for EHOME's liking, so they just want to take that away. And Storm isn't necessarily a terrible matchup for Death Prophet mid. Like, DP most definitely has the advantage, but we've seen that Mikasa, even in adverse situations, still manages to do very well. I think it's a pretty solid ban. I would be very surprised if Beastmaster makes it through all the way without being picked.
What do they grab here, EHOME?
I mean, they kind of want a Vision Hero, right? Because they're playing against Batrider.
But they need another support.
No, but what I mean is they can just they can put Clink safe, offlane Void, and then... All right, they're going to pick Tusk instead.
Yeah.
And this is the more aggressive early game hero, like by a wide margin. Okay. I'm guessing it's just going to be old 11 again, and they're just going to go for the Iron Talon.
Well, I guess so. And then who plays the Faceless Void? Old Lana?
Wait, no.
No, it'll be old 11 Void still. It's usually even though old 11, Tusk is old 11's hero.
It's support Tusk, for sure.
Yes.
I think it's Lanham Tusk.
I mean, it's got to be an 11
Oracle.
Void.
Yeah, an 11 Void. Yeah, you're right.
But I won't be surprised they do switch it around, because old 11 was always the guy who was just amazing on the Tusk. You know, that is his hero. But as you said, he is the core player.
Oh.
Okay, sneaking through the Bristleback Aya combo to finish this off.
So
okay.
Dual offlane, perhaps.
Yeah, Yang on the Bristle, so he's going to take it to the off and... We'll probably expect CFY helping him out in that lane if necessary. And, okay, indeed, yeah. Old 11, you know, regardless of the plays he could bring on the Tusk, he's going to step aside and let Old Lanham keep that support Tusk position. And it will be Old 11 on the core offlane Faceless Void. Isosize Clinks and will be finished up by the chicken himself on Death Prophet. Over the side of Ichigame Reborn, yeah, nothing too surprising apart from it's, yeah, is indeed. We're going to be given the treat of the Bristleback offlane by Yang, the 8.5k. Bristle, the highest MMR in China.
He has had just amazing performances throughout the entire qualifiers so far. He's been the player that I would say, not necessarily MVP for all of it, but I don't think he's had really a bad game.
Okay.
You know, maybe one or two, but considering the caliber of teams that he's against and how hard of a region China actually is, I'd say this guy has been more or less on fire. So, you know, VGR, obviously, they're one win away for being that regional qualifier. If EHOME manage to take this, they'll be bringing it to a game five to decide who goes straight to TI as a team who gets to play the whole tournament versus wildcard. Huge, huge game for both teams.
There we go. Time and first branch destruction. I'm going to say 20 to 30.
That's pretty early. But I'll go with you, actually.
They can do it.
First player to get 50 lances.
There's Lycans, there's Klinkses, and
DPs. I'm going to say Lycan is going to get 50 lances first. Because here's the thing, right?
Yeah.
Like, if we assume that it's going to be a contested lane, that Bristleback Io going top, that means that the Klinks might have a harder time getting the CS than the Lycan.
Oh, that's physical damage. Would you go with the Bristle? No, I guess
Death Prophet. Death Prophet.
I'm going to see it as VGR doing well there.
Okay.
Play with the first triple kill again. I'm going in all with the end picks.
Actually, first triple kill, I would say Old Chicken. I think DP is more of a triple kill hero than a Lycan.
Okay.
We'll see, though.
We'll see.
Now, with that happening, it's going to be like a level 1 5 versus 5 fight and the Wisp is going to get 3 kills. Because that's just how...
I mean, FY could get a triple.
That's how it works.
They are looking to potentially set up for a fight up top. Both teams will be looking for this position. See if it goes down there. They're already moving down towards the bottom. E-home. So they don't want to contest top. They want to avoid the fight. DGC and Endar down here. I mean, if anything, see if they'll be able to grab a couple. But lane-wise, looks like, yeah, indeed, nothing too surprising. It is going to be what we anticipated.
The dual offlane should be pulling a lot of attention here from E-home. Like, they can probably kill the Wisp. Like, Tusk is one of the better heroes at getting in on the Wisp in the early game. And with that and a Fortune's End, they could potentially just get the kill on him really early because Klinks hits real hard. And it's all physical DPS and FY has zero armor. We'll see, though. Yang could be abandoned for a bit. He did start with regen, though. No Iron Talon, so I'm assuming that it's just going to be FY doing a bit of blocking before he makes his way up to that top lane. So Yang is going to bristle his way out of here.
So lane's starting to come out. The mid lane, you know, Mikasa Bat. Up against the DP. Pretty even lane, or is someone going to struggle here?
I think the DP has the advantage. I think DP has the advantage over, like, a lot of heroes.
Yeah. This was such, just such a strong lane. What always gets the farm with the Crypsal.
Yeah. I mean, I suppose if you get too many Napalm stacks, there is a chance that Mikasa can dive, but with Spirit Siphon, like, it has the slow component, and you're just draining health the entire time, so it's just a hard commitment to justify. Oh, Lanham is so low right now.
That's what Ion Howl does for you. The Howl came out and FY just started to punch back.
He's going to have to kill himself here to creeps.
Oh, looks like we're going to be the old lag. Am I going to miss anything if I go for might miss some action mid because there's 4 stacks on this old chicken. Alright, TP comes through. He's going to be fine. Bottom lane? No, not going to be looking for an opening here. Old Lanham's just going to look to eye them up. Oh, looks like we're good actually. Lag's gone. No, it hasn't gone. My goodness, I'm going to reconnect. If I miss a kill, I'm going to cry.
I think you're good, actually. Or maybe you're not.
Oh, god damn it!
Okay. Old 11 got away. He's fine.
Okay, I'm good. Be good.
Everything's fine. This is fine. Relax. It's Dota 2, Owen. But it's actually turning out to be FY sticking around mid, maybe a little bit more. He's getting harassed quite a bit here from Old Chicken.
Did we fix it? We didn't fix it. Damn it!
I think sometimes it's just not going to get
We'll try another reconnect. I mean, this is so bad.
Yeah.
Someone's been TPing in for 1,000 seconds. In fact, he never arrived.
1,000.
Okay. Surprise, surprise. Lanham and Fenrir here looking to burst down the IO, but he gets himself away. Tethers across to Mikasa. And now Yang moving in. Quill Spray stacks beginning to build up. He's got a Mango as well if he wants to go super. How many may just do that? Chasing down Old Lanham and an Old Chicken. They've already found 1 kill onto the Oracle. They're going to be able to find themselves more. Old Lanham, he's going to pop. And now they turn towards Old Chicken. He's already had the Quill Spray stack stuck up. They're going to be able to find themselves a 3rd kill by the looks of it. VGR may have lost one, but double kill for Mikasa. And a very, very nice fight here at the start of the game for them. 3-1.
Man, they were so aggressively positioned there. They were, like, behind enemy lines. They were really looking to try to get FY. But that tether, bringing it back towards the river, he finds the bounty rune as well, so he's able to keep himself alive even longer, allowing for the opportunity that, you know, VGR needed to get some counter kills. It's a really, really big win for them here in this early game.
Bottom lane. All level 4. Still finding the XP. DDCN and unable to do too much about it. But the CS is there. Still favorable CS at the moment in the safe lane for E-Home. Ice having slightly better time across the map. Mikasa continuously putting the pressure in on this mid. And double the CS. I mean, Mikasa, he's just been playing the mid lane so well today. We've seen numerous times him just outright win the lane.
Yeah. Surprising, too, because, you know, this guy's... he's obviously a sub for the team, but he's also the team coach. So... He obviously knows his stuff, but he's also a very mechanically talented player. And, you know, the rest of VGR are still doing pretty well in the lanes. I suppose the Lycan isn't farming quite as well as Ice, but you can also say that VGR were committing quite a few heroes to trying to get those kills towards mid. And Yang taking some damage here. Should be fine, though.
Yeah, walk it off. I mean, they 5 stacks on Old Chicken. He has got to be careful.
He just does not care.
Okay, the stakes are now one off. Yang. And Enfoy coming in with a backup. The snowball coming through. They'll take down Mikasa. Let's see if Yang can clean up anything in return. Stacks building up onto Ice. Needs one more. Yeah, he'll get it. Takes down Clicks. Moving on to Old Lana, but at the same time, in comes Fenrir. They're looking to turn Yang. He's got one more Quill Spray, and it'll be enough to take down the Tusk. So two for two trade. Yang continuing to find a lot out of this. And barely gets himself away. And I'm going to try for reconnect. Andy, tell me I don't miss anything.
Nah, you're good. I think everyone's more or less just backing up at this point. But those kills, you know, Old Chicken, he started to pull ahead in the middle lane. He's already level 5, but I guess the biggest problem is that he's got 9 creep kills at 4 minutes. 9 CS. That is really, really low. Granted, he does have Crypt Swarm, so I'm assuming if anyone's going to be able to catch back up, it's going to be a Death Prophet. There's just been so many small skirmishes in this game. Like, it's 5 minutes in. There's 8 kills. It's more than 1 kill a minute. Everyone's just battling.
Have we done it? We haven't done it.
You have definitely not done it.
Yeah, I do apologize to this guy's at home. Not a lot we can do really to get through the Great Firewall of China. We'll maybe try again soon. Unless we'll watch this down bottom. DDC being gone on there into the snowball. Straight away, they'll take the kill.
That was so nice, actually. He uses the snowball to disjoint the glimpse to make sure that none of the heroes are sent back. They go straight in, they get the kill. Easy peasy. Top tower is under
attack. Now 5-4 at the moment. A lot on the line for these teams here. This could be the last game for both of them. So that would, of course, be good news for VGR. Bottom lane, as on toward 11, DDC. Let's got a glimpse of 20 seconds, so not able to really try and set something up. Mid lane, Old Lenham's trying to have a bit of a go onto Mikasa, but he's fine. Curry actually kind of coming in and teasing him there. Yang, level 4 at the moment on the off lane. Very close to having the money for, I guess, what he just picks up the arcane boots first on the bristle.
I'm not sure,
actually. Does he go for the treads? I mean, treads are nice as well with the tread switch.
No, I mean, I like both, honestly. Yeah. But I think that arcanes are, like, at least one pair are very nice when you have a wisp. It just depends on what your role is at as the bristle. I think he might want to be a little bit more frontline-centric, so maybe he opts to go for treads and vanguard instead. Or maybe he just, like, skips finishing boots entirely and goes for, like, the ring of health into vanguard.
He's saving up the money here. Mikasa trying to clean up some of these camps. We've actually got Ice moving around here with the level 6. I mean, could try and go for Yang. Yang, fairly low. Yeah, Ice. He's going to straight up dive the tower with a snowball in. They'll get the kill. Nice little bit of a rotation there from Ice, catching Yang. Totally off guard. He did not expect that to happen.
Yeah, that rotation is very hard to anticipate, because even though they have sentries down, they don't have any observers on top of the sentries, so the vision is just not really helpful. And unfortunately, Mikasa didn't notice the fact that the creep camp that he was killing was not giving him fully XP. So if you're paying close attention, you can see that you're sharing EXP with somebody else if they're just in range. And that would have given them the information they needed to know that Klinks was there, because he's the only hero within this.
Bottom lane, Yang. He's headed down here to get some of the farm. Old Chicken's there as well. They want to try and make a go. Old Lemon does have a chrono. She's not going to commit it, but Old Chicken's popped the ghost here. So we'll see how VGR want to play around this, if they do want to try and defend, or they do just accept the loss of this tower because of the exorcism push. And it looks like that may be the case. N's not in any position to fight. And Old Levin's already there just zoning out any kind of reaction. So Old Chicken will be able to do a significant amount of damage to this tower. Same time. Oh, looks like a bit of action kicking off mid. Mikasa in trouble. He's trying to burn down Ice. Will he be able to do it? Oh, and turning up.
That crit, man.
He'll clean out a couple there on the Lycan.
That shapeshift crit. What a life-saving, crit that was. But VGR is still looking pretty solid here in the early game. They're going to be able to counter pressure mid after getting that those couple of kills. Old Chicken TPs with not very much mana. Guess he does have some stick charges, though. And yeah.
I'm going to try one more. Third time lucky. Andy.
Third time's a charm. Nothing is being missed
right now.
Worry not. The only thing that you're missing is a couple of dropped frames. Nothing too crazy. But, you know, right now both teams kind of getting some farm in the laning phase. I guess you could say that eHome are getting a bit more out of it because their Void was uncontested, more or less. It was just like Lycan versus Void safe lane.
Oh, we actually lost. This is...
Yeah, you ain't got anything.
This is unfortunate. Apologies for this, guys. Not a lot we can do at the moment. The lag seems to choose a PC and stick with it.
Oh, and he is dead. I mean, I don't know how much of that you guys actually saw. But
it's like, suddenly someone's there, suddenly they're not.
Okay. Well, Mikasa did manage to buy his Blink Dagger before he fell there in the middle lane. But I'm kind of feeling like E-Homer getting maybe slightly ahead from this early game, especially after killing the Batrider and the Lycan consecutively. They're pressuring the Tier 2 in the safe lane of EGR. And there is no Disruptor Ultimate out on the field just yet. I suppose he'll be able to buy the Tome of Experience or... Yeah, actually, I think DDC buys it over the Wisp, so... Yeah, it's going to be Treads on the Bristle as we expected. I think he'll probably just go into Vanguard or at least buy like a... Oh, he has Magic Sicken if he uses Raindrops already, so that's like the core on Bristle. Those items are like so necessary because you want to be really involved in the early game fight, so without them, you're just not really quite as efficient as you need to be.
I mean, but with EGL, they are going to try something here with the Blink Smoke. See, they can catch, maybe get a jump on mid. It's just Fenrir though, not necessarily the biggest of kills, but it will be a kill nonetheless. Yeah, they'll just jump in, no messing for VGR. They'll pick up a kill onto Fenrir. Take down the Oracle, and that will free up the space for to find a tier 1 as well.
They can't even go to Roche, honestly.
Yeah.
I mean, they have a Lycan with a Vlad, so... I mean, I don't know if they will, but the potential is always there. They have the level 6 on the IO, and I'm pretty sure they're sending out a Tome of Experience right now. Yep, so Disruptor's going to have 6 too.
So he's chasing down end here. See if he feels like he's got the burst to attempt for this one. On his own, it's
way too scary.
Yeah, he needs backup. Fenrir's around. And it looks like VGR just getting themselves in position to try for another tier 1, putting the pressure on top.
It's nice rotations because VGR's pushing potential is very high. Oh, bottom lane. Old 11.
There's back. They've caught him in the Static Storm. They'll bring in end as well with a relocate from FY. And they will punish the Void's positioning. Disruptor, such a great hero to set up for these relocate games.
Yeah, Void doesn't really have a response to that either. It's like, Static Storm's down, you're pretty much just a goner.
Straight away up top with a re-relocate back, they're looking to dive. They're going to move in onto Fenrir. Can they do anything about this? Fenrir being chased down into the tree line. Looks like he's got nothing to offer for himself. As they'll beat down upon him, VGR find themselves a second kill. Quick succession, and the tier 1 is now exposed if they want to go for the takedown. Hiding the trees, that's going to TP out, and well, ooh.
Old Chicken comes in with his ulti popped.
Yeah.
Looking for something, but not going to find it. I got to say, the Lycan pick is doing absolute work this game.
Yeah.
For the side
it's
of
EGR. Good pick here, friend.
They just don't have a lot of lockdown for him. Like, they actually just need to chrono him if they want to kill. So you need to expend chrono and Death Prophet ultimate to kill one hero. That is a really scary thing to think about. Now, granted, we haven't really seen the full 5-man potential of E-Holmes. Mikasa? Probably dead.
Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah, boop. There he goes. But no, I feel like maybe there's going to have to be too much commitment in terms of ultimates to kill the cores of EGR. And that's kind of what they can play around. So, you know, once Yang finishes his Vanguard, he's pretty close right now. And the Lycan gets, like, his book finished. Then all of a sudden, you have these two really tanky cores that without your ultimates, you just simply cannot kill. You won't have the damage until Ice 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 starts to get, you know, maybe the Deso finish.
I mean, they're eyeing up Yang. They could try for...
He's dead.
Yeah, like with the Tusk coming around as well, Yang's just... He's way, way too far out. There we have it. He'll try and walk it off, but yeah, no way.
I mean, when you get 3v1s and you don't have your Vanguard yet, you're probably not living through that.
Shuts him down. He's gonna fall back a few hundred gold as well. Getting caught out there. Radiant's top tower is under attack. 10-10 at the moment. 13 minutes in. Overall net worth difference.
I mean,
E-Home's favor, but
it's just a tower difference.
Yeah,
like they have a one tower lead. Middle lane.
Good scan as well.
Oh
yeah, not good enough.
There's just no living through that. Like,
yeah, they've got such a good catch, especially with the what they're using. You know, obviously just using the Lycan's walls to scout out, so they can get the vision for the glimpse.
Yeah, it's a really nice combo. Yeah. That's why I was talking about a vision hero when we were mentioning Beastmaster and whatnot, to make sure that you can abuse that glimpse and instead of going for the beast, they get the wolves.
Oh, from the side, here we go with the jump in, trying to set up. There'll be a snowball. So she's going to put Old Lanham in a less than favorable position. Can they actually kill him though? Well, looks like he's going to be able to walk it off. Damage being low. In fact, the walls actually chopping out. Okay, yeah. Mikasa, no messing. Jumps in. Throws down the lasso. And they'll find the kill. TP
there's a chrono.
Nice size. Can he find the opening? Hold 11 indeed. Looking for the chrono setup. He's trying to get FY. He'll actually just chrono Yang on the back of it. Jump board onto the IO. He's got to hope for a few bashes here. Potentially the tether's out. And oh, the bash came in, but a little too late. FY was already there with the tether. Ice. One touch and okay. Hold 11 jumps now. Could he kill this IO? FY finally will pop. Zeiss finds the final arrow. And Ehome, they're chasing this down for more. It's questionable whether they'll actually be able to get anything in. It doesn't look like Will. Batrider and Yang are out. And they will survive. Yang very close to having the bit booster money, so he can finish off his Vanguard. Looking towards end, he's a few hundred away from having the recipe for Necro.
I would say overall this game is still incredibly close. Like, the only thing I suppose that VGR has the advantage in right now is their mobility. Their catch potential is obviously a little bit better. And they're not ultimate reliant. Like, they don't need Lasso. You know, they can just run at somebody with the Lycan. A glimpse into a static storm or kinetic field can just be a kill on its own.
Oh, old 11. Not again. Caught out by the same old combo.
Oh, that's got to feel so bad. And without Void, are they going to run to the pit? Do they even know this is going on right now? Okay, they do not know. Or if they do, they're not reacting fast enough.
Oh, yeah, that's a... It's a good bit of play for Ehome, yeah. They'll happily lose a hero if it means the space for a Roshan.
And with that, Ice secures his Desolator as well. So Deso, kind of surprised that Death Prophet took the Aegis, to be honest, but, you know, I don't think there's actually many, like, better carriers of the Aegis in this game.
No.
Maybe the Void, because he's always being focused before he can get his ultimate off, but that's about it. And obviously the Void was dead, because he got killed bottom lane. But a very nice move for Mihome, taking the Roshan out from under the nose of Ichi. Should be able to apply some pressure here. All the tier 1s on the side of Ichi are down. But taking a team fight with Chrono available, Death Prophet ulti, and the second life on the DP should be within their reach.
Well, so let's see what you can find out here. Has spotted out Mikasa and eyes towards the defender. The control's there and the damage as well.
Ouch. That damage.
No escape for Mikasa.
Interestingly enough, FY has opted out of boots this game. He just wanted to buy the Ghost Scepter.
I'm going to guess, yeah, if you get the money up, it's a very worthy investment, yeah, against the lineup of Vika.
It's just a value of purchase because they have almost... I mean, they have some magic damage, but it's not the thing that you're really worried about. It's more like the Desolator clings to the, you know, the Exorcism Ghost just punching you and you just die. So that'll help him out pretty significantly in these upcoming engagements. And Yang's making his way towards the Crimson. He's almost got it. Question is, can they fight into Ehome?
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Let's have a look. Ehome. Backing up mid lane. There's the jump in. They've caught Ice, and that's a big pick. Very big pick indeed. They've trapped him in the field, and they'll take him down. Nearly, nearly bringing DDC down with him.
Oh, they want to go on this.
They do. They're Ehome with a wraparound smoke. They want to punish the fact that VGR have committed quite a bit for that. Jumping forward, old 11 reveals himself. He's going to get glimpse back immediately. Great glimpse from DDC.
And now they're going to meet up with the rest of the team, so now they can't go. FY is going to have relocate if he wants to try to go for a save on top of the chrono, but I think the rest of VGR just want to bail, and they will get out.
Absolutely. This is not the vision of the cat. To take down any of the heroes. So VGR again with a nice place, and they are just creating space and allowing the Lycan to get more and more under his belt. And nearly enough money for the level 2 Necro. The farming continues on top of the Treads and the Vladimirs. Ideally, they themselves probably want to look to get Roche, but obviously now at this position again, they're going to have to wait a while for that to come back. But I mean, what's the play here really from Ehome? Do they try and do as much as they can during this period? They have to go push with this Aegis?
I think that they want to try to do more with their Aegis than what they have been. And the main reason is because VGR just simply put have too much catch. Their map control is great. Relocate, Batrider initiation, glimpse. There's so much punish and multiple ways of taking team fights, whereas Ehome are kind of stuck to one style of play. It's like fight around our double ulti and hope that we win our five man. I mean, it's being showcased here. They're just smoking up right away. They don't want to delay the game any more than they have to, because they realize that it's inherent risk when, you know, one or two picks can just be a set of racks when you're playing against a team with a Lycan. It's a very scary thing to think about, but they're going for the posturing here, forcing the rest of VGR back into the base. Tier 2s going to be available to be sieged if they want to go for it, but they're more interested in finding the fights right now. But unfortunately for them, they will find none.
And what's the iron build-up for Bristol? He's picked up a band of elves. Is he just going to go SMY after the Crimson?
I suppose so.
Yeah.
It's not bad. I mean, I personally would have liked to see him pick up like a casual plate mail or something, because there's already a Deso up. Just so we can be like the tankier frontline. And I think that physical damage is the thing that he's going to have to worry about this game. It's not going to be magic. But at the same time, if you build Crimson and plate mail, you're not really a threat in the fight because you don't do any damage. So SNY is like the hybrid choice. Survivability, and it keeps you relevant in terms of damage output.
I mean, we see here, look, Eheim absolutely desperate to push, and they will commit the ghost. Now, BGR, what do they do about this? They have Blink Lasso up online, Static Storm, Relocate, everything is there if they do want to try and jump in. It looks like they may just sit back and have to let this tier 2 go. Fortification comes out, just trying to slow down, tease off the push of Eheim. And Eheim actually respecting the fight from VGR, a little bit scared, and not actually going to stick around for this tier 2. They're going to retreat and back up, so. Not able to be successful with the full extent of the push.
But you can tell, like, the sense of urgency they have. They really want to try to do something. The later the game goes, the harder it's going to be, I think, for the heroes like Tusk and Oracle to really find any room in the fights. Because you're just going to get ran at by, like, a Lycan. And if that happens, you don't have a countermeasure unless you have Ghost Scepter. So it's a really scary thing to think about if you're Eheim right now. Knowing that VGR are not relying on cooldowns. They can fight at any given point. That's another reason why Eheim's lineup is a little bit harder to play. Because if you use the Ghost and you use the Chrono, and it's not resulting in a teamfight win, VGR have a ton of time to pressure you, and oh boy, Fenrir.
Static Storm down as well. Fenrir can't save himself. Yank, frontlining this. They'll take down one. And this is creating the space for them to beat down, take a tower, and pops the ult. He's ready to fight, rolling in. Eheim, they're there, but old Lanham, he's going to get punished immediately. They'll find themselves a second kill, VG Reborn. And on top of the second kill, they'll almost certainly find themselves a second tower. And this is what Eheim are going to be scared about. You lose one fight, you're losing a hell of a lot of buildings.
Yeah. Yeah. Necrobook Lycan does a tremendous amount of damage to buildings. Old 11 getting reload on.
I've got a lasso. They've got a lasso because it can contain him and just get the time walk off. Can they actually catch him down? Blink in 3 seconds. He'll turn. He's going to chrono. No messing him with ice there. They can pick themselves at least one kill. Can they get themselves anything more, though? Doesn't look like it. Mikasa jumps in, looking for the control. False promise, keeping old 11 alive. VGR now on the retreat. Crimson Guard popped by Yang, so it's impossible for Eheim to find the damage in that they need to. And old 11 jumps it all, but the Quill Spray stacks were too much. They've lost the Faceless Void. And now ice, he's got to run, he's got to hide, gets himself out of there. So they chrono, they kill FY, but they lose the void for it. Not worth it at all for Eheim.
Yeah, their ultimates are not being used to the efficiency that they need them to be. And that's really going to be the story of the game here, is what Eheim get out of the chrono, what they get out of the exorcism. And right now, using your ultimate defensively and trading a core for a support is not the way. Like, you need better exchanges than that if you want to take a good mid-late game. However, there is one really good thing for Eheim right now, is the fact that Diffusal Blade is going to be done soon on Ice. That means whenever he decides to go for the kill on the Wisp, he'll be able to get it with relative ease. Same thing for the Disruptor. And it's also a good way to get rid of Dust if the enemy team is focusing you. You'll have a way of getting yourself out of danger. So, a really solid pickup here from Ice. Probably the best thing I think he can get in the situation. And it could allow them to take some solid engagements.
Mikasa, ready to lean in with a smoke. He's got the lasso in a couple of seconds. Actually jumping in now. Doesn't actually have the lasso available, but at the same time, Static Storm onto 11, in comes the party with them bringing themselves in. So put themselves in a snowball, but they're still going to die. Two of them down. Ghosts are out, but they're ready to chase for more. The Glint Spike's there onto Ultra Chicken. The Quill Spray stack up. So does the Napalm. Double buyback, though, from the side of Eheim. They're looking to fight back into this. Can they actually find anything, though? Yang TP's out. He's not going to make it. The stun's there. Bristleback, maybe the one to pay of his life. He's incredibly tanky. Not tanky enough. The final nukes come out. And Eheim find the kill onto both the Bristle and the Lycan off the back of those buybacks.
It was definitely worth it. Eheim could not continue to lose fights that way. At the beginning of the fight, it looked like there would be a chance for VGR to just kind of rout them because the Tusk Snowball only bought a couple of seconds, and at the end of the day, they still ended up losing both the heroes. But because of the fact that Ice just starts laying into the Lycan and forces him back, like, End couldn't keep up with the damage output just because of the item progression that Ice has. And he didn't even have the Diffusal at that point, so now he's going to hit even harder. it's a glimmer of hope here for eHome in this game, especially considering that Roshan is going to be spawning right now. This is some crazy good timing for them.
Oh, we fixed the lag, Andy.
That's nice.
Beautiful. Yeah, we did.
Nicely done.
Here we have it. Just as the game is, you know, continues to step up. Oh, ice. He's going to go for the pick.
Oh, no, he's going for FY.
Okay. Ghost Scepter coming out post defusal. Will force another charge. FY still alive here. Oh, he's going to live. They've kept him up. Snowball forward. The blink back from Bat is baiting them deep. They're right in the middle of VGR's lineup now. The Chrono comes out. It's only going to catch Mikasa.
Oh, my God.
Crimp Swarm from Old Chicken ripping through two of them. Ice kept alive by the False Promise, but now it's the cleanup potentially from N. And Yang just running at the heroes. Old Chicken jumped down by the big bad wolf. They have lost three, but they lose two in return, eHome. And N continue to go from strength to strength. Overall, the fight numbers do favor eHome, only slightly though.
Oh, that could have been a total disaster for VGR. But at the end of the day, heroes teleporting in at the right time. The two tanky cores of VGR salvaging an otherwise really rough fight for them. And eHome, they're not going to be able to get Roche. The thing that was so heartbreaking for eHome there is the fact that they had a hero inside the Roshan pit seconds before he spawned. But he left the pit, and then they saw an opportunity to go for a fight, and they went for that instead, because obviously you don't know exactly when Roshan is going to spawn. You have a 3-minute window. So they just assume, okay, we take one good fight, maybe we can go for Roshan after the fact, but now it's going to have to be a full-on bloodbath to see who gets it.
Yeah, VGR are going to be ready for that. They are going to be ready for that fight. Both teams, in fact. Chronosphere still down for 40 seconds, though, so that's like the only kind of timing that both sides... Maybe we'll be looking around. The shapeshift back available in less than 20, so end. He'll be ready to join. So after the Necro, the Vlads, he's picked up the Hyperstone. I guess this game, it just feels it's not really a necessity for a BKB on the Lycan.
I suppose BKB is like, it's not really that good this game.
No, they've got the physical.
You can still get punched, you can get chronoed. There's a lot of damage coming out from the Clinks and the Death Prophet ultimate. I don't think it's really necessary. I think AC is the better choice, which is what he's going for now, because he already has the Hyperstone.
Yeah, it's great for him, and I guess it's great with the Bristle as well. And I guess sometimes you would maybe want the Bristle to build it, but at the same time, if he's not finding the same pace of farm as you, you know, you leave it up to the Lycan. And I guess that allows Bristle to maybe think about, I guess, with this kind of build SNY, do you then go into the Basher Abyssal, or do you still look for something like the Shiva's Guard to help him in the fight?
I mean, Basher or Abyssal is kind of what we used to see, but the fact is he already has Crimson, so maybe he goes for, like, the Basher.
That's true, yeah.
And then he just gets something else. I'm not sure. Like, the Crimson kind of told me that BGR wanted to do a lot during the early mid-game, which they have. I mean, I'd say that for a good while they were leading by a good chunk just because of their team fighting capabilities and how often they could actually go for engagements, but now it seems like building the Basher Abyssal after... It still could be on the table. Like, I'm not completely dismissing it. It's more just, like, a weird thing, you know? Because you got to buy two Vanguards.
Yeah, absolutely. It's, in concept, it's a strange idea. eHome, they are kind of still hovering around this pit. I guess just kind of asking themselves, are they going to be okay and go for it? They'll put the sentry down. They know that the wolf spotted them out. So they know that VGR know that they're there.
They have everything up, though. Yeah. So they're going to bait it. They're not going to pop any of their abilities, saving the full duration of the Exorcism until VGR actually get there. And they know... Oh, man. Actually, this is so scary. This is so freaking scary. Against Batrider, like, taking this positioning inside of the pit...
I mean, this grouping up as well. Okay. Old Lanham jumping out. Old 11.
They're going to scout with a sigil.
So what kind of a jumping they want to go for? Yang. Okay. Siphon. Silence. He just stands there. Yang just AFKs it at this point.
Yeah, he does not care at all.
Ice sidelines. Okay. Mikasa, he's grabbed ice. The snowball will come out. Ice is going to be able to live through it. At the same time, Yang trying to make a go on this on the side. The igloo. Oh, he's trapped the wolf. He's trapped.
Oh, the shards.
He's absolutely trapped by the igloo. They'll still find the ice kill. N still living through this. There'll be a buyback from ice. Mikasa chasing down Old Lanham. Chrono comes out from Old 11 onto Yang and onto DDC, but they don't have the damage to bring down this bristle back. Maybe with the ghost they can. They'll chase him down. Jumping forward, but FY comes across, keeping Yang alive. The quills race back. Are sticking up here as Yang still playing around it. He's
ice is coming back.
Can they kill him? Old Lanham with the wraparound. He's a little bit scared. Jules setups there. Mikasa as well. EGR. He's going to actually go for the TP out. Yang says, I'm done. And they say, no, you're not, mate. You're sticking around for this one. Punch to the backside. Yang's down as well. And eHome They do it here. Gem hits the deck. They'll pick that one up. Oh, F1.
Oh!
Oh, double kill. You what?
He almost got the triple. Oh my god, they were sitting in the Firefly for so long because they saw the gem on the ground that when FY came back from his relocate, he got two kills.
Oh my goodness.
Ehome actually still end up with a very decisive victory there.
Yes.
They're not going to be able to get Roshan though, and they had to buy back on Ice. So as bad as it looked for VGR to lose that fight, the commitment from Ehome is still very heavy. It's not as if they walked into that fight and were able to get everything for free. Okay, Ice is going to try to solo it. He might be able to, actually. And heroes are dead for quite a while, so yeah, Ice is going to solo it. All right, there you go. So big victory here for Ehome. I forgot that Clink just has a ridiculous amount of health. And with the Sigil on top of that coming in here from Lineup, it should be fairly easy for them to finish this off. So huge victory there. I think the momentum now shifting pretty heavily in favor of them.
Aegis now onto Ice. Looking in much better shape as this game scales up. DP. He's at the top, old chicken. BKB, Shiva's guard. You know, he's so hard to bring down in these fights, as we're seeing. You've got the Batrider trying to work towards his jewels, Mikasa. Yang, still a fair bit off his next item. And the Lycan. And who did have a great start now, just behind the Death Prophet. Plate Mail and Hyperstone in the bank, so. It's closing in on that AC. Has he got anything on the courier? No, not yet. And Yang? Okay, Yang with the Ogre Club. Looks like the Bristlebat's just going to go for a straight BKB this game. After the Sun Jinyasha.
I don't know about BKB, honestly. Like, what are you BKBing? A Silence? Maybe a Fortune's End?
I mean, what else? Could he go for, could it be?
It could be Echo.
What about Halberd for the Clinks?
Yeah, Halberd or Echo. I think both are really good.
Halberd could be nice.
That's true, because Ice, he's making BKB right now. If he
scouts
the Ogre Club, I think it's much more likely to be Echo Saber.
Okay.
Lincoln's now finished up here on old 11. Really solid for stopping the Batrider initiation when you go in. And there's not really anything else that's going to be able to eat the Lincolns itself unless the bat goes in. Like, Mikasa has to force staff prior to throwing out the lasso, and then you have no way of pulling the hero out. It's a little bit awkward. Maybe you can hope for, like, a Bristlebat goo or something like that to start the fight. Oh, okay, he has Yules now, so that'll help. Yeah, so like blink Yules, then lasso and force away. But yeah, still a very close game between both these teams. Ehome with a slight edge here. Mostly in the experience department after winning that last team fight and then securing Roshan, but they are walking down this middle lane. Not popping the ghost just yet. They want to make sure they can save it for the potential high ground push or the fight. And they'll take the free tier 2.
Time to push in. Okay, sir. Jumps in, forces back Exorcism now up. See what they can do to deal with this one. Fortification, any kind of jump in potential. We'll see if VGR can find themselves a catch, but it's going to be a tricky one. They're healing up old chicken. Just allowing him to hang around, let the ghosts do their work, and the tier 3 will fall. Ehome. They'll continue to power in. They're looking for the first set of Rex here in the mid lane. Any kind of answer? No, the melee Rex, they're going to drop. Ehome, find it.
We were 2 minutes off, Owen.
God damn it. Let's see what VGR can do in response. Shiva's got BKB out from old chicken. He's moving in for more. Ice on the front. Look at the DZC. Takes down the Disruptor. He's actually going to get popped himself, but he's going to be back in a few seconds. With the Aegis, jumping Link has put immediately a false promise to remove the lasso. Ice contained by the Yule Scepter. Can they bring him down? Dust is out. They'll take down the Clinks at least. They've already lost
bottom. They lost bottom racks. Ed is just ratting them this whole time. There's three heroes here.
Okay, okay. And Clinks is dead for a hell of a long time.
All right.
Buyback's still on cooldown. He doesn't have the money.
MVP. I was wondering where the Lycan was. All right, it's a little bit late.
All right.
It's only almost 6 in the morning.
It's 6 a.m.
Okay.
Okay.
So very well played there from Ed, equalizing an otherwise really rough situation. The dynamic of the game likely to not change too much. I would actually say, ultimately, that's VGR's victory. Because they kill 2 times, they get the Aegis, they get the Clinks.
Yes.
And they trade evenly in regards to Rax. So, all things considered, that was VGR's win for sure.
Absolutely. And, you know, looking at some items, other big items coming around the corner. Yang's nearly got the BKB finished. Lotus Orb is done by old Lanham. Anything else that we're looking to see close up fairly shortly? Well, Batrider, after that fight, 3k gold on Mikasa. I guess build-wise, probably looks for the Refresher next, or does he himself need a BKB, do you feel?
I think BKB for him would be more reasonable.
Okay.
Some of the other heroes in this game. Just because, you know, Death Prophet Silence can still be a bit of a nuisance. You can still get Yules cast on you. Snowball in can be kind of annoying. But yeah, I think BKB for him is all right. I mean, we've seen stuff like Aghanim's. We've seen Refresher as well. I think both of the items have their merits, but BKB is a safe choice.
Shadowblade will be the item of choice for all 11, so... He, at this point, he can certainly have a great potential of finding those perfect Chronospheres. And we've seen how much they can get done in the fight. You know, just allowing old Chicken and Ice to sit in the sidelines and pummel into the big purple ball.
I guess we'll just have to see who wins the next couple of engagements. Because that's really all it boils down to now, is who gets the jump, you know. Who wins the actual team fight. And Eholm, they're going in.
Absolutely, old Chicken leads the way. But don't actually have the Void with them here. And oh, and walks right into this one. He's going to go for the ult first, and he will be able to run. He won't be able to hide. They'll still take the kill, and Batrider as well to fall.
That's no buyback on Lycan.
A full minute here where Eholm can go to work. Still a tier 2 standing top, but they can certainly push this lane in and try and go for the bottom lane. Indeed, pings are coming out. There'll be a buyback from the bat. VGR realizing that they need everything that they can to hold this defense without the Lycan.
They don't know Lycan doesn't have buyback because he just bought his AC. If they knew, they would just keep pushing.
Playing it safely here at home, and that might come back to bite them in the foot. A potential opening, but unable to realize that could have been a clean push down the bottom lane. Yeah, just too scared of that Lycan's return capability. Even though he didn't have shapeshift as well.
I mean, it's not that long of a cooldown. Probably it's at level 3, it's only 60 seconds. But he's only he just hit level 16, actually. Did he miss skill? Why does he not have 3 points in the ult? He must have saved it.
What if he was to do the stat math?
I'm guessing he just held on to the point and he'll skill it when he's alive. Or not, I don't know.
I think he skills stats.
If he did, that is a pretty big misclick. He's 30 seconds off the cooldown.
Wait, I noticed that. Where's these Agi points coming from? What's the plus 6 Agi from? He's to put 3 points. No, he can't. He can't have. Wait.
I mean, technically, 3 points on his stats gives you 6 agi.
Yeah, but he can't have done that at level 16. Oh, wait, no, he could have. No,
he
could have.
Yeah,
he could have. No, he can't have. No, he's put 15. He's put 14 points into skills. I'm confused right now.
Oh, no, Vlad's is 2 to all stats because of the.
Vlad's is 2 to all stats, yeah.
Vlad's
2
is 2 to all stats because of the headdress.
And then he's put. Yeah, he's put a point in. So that, as you said, must have been a miss.
He did miss up.
That was a miss skill.
That's a pretty costly miss skill, actually.
Yeah.
Because you're losing 20% critical damage, and you're losing 30 seconds off the cooldown.
All right. He's nearly there to level 17, but yeah, as you said, just little slip-ups, and you got to keep your cool at this level of the game. Grand Finals.
And everything is going to be up here in about 60 seconds for the side of Eholm, just waiting on the Chrono more than anything else. Old Chicken has Exorcism up and available.
Old 11 with the Shadow Blade. Oh, jumps forward. Here we go. Static Storm gets laid down. They've already lost the Disruptor. Mikasa with the control to 11, but the False Promise comes out. And Eholm move forward and running around. In fact, he's running away. He doesn't know what he's doing in this fight. They've already lost one. Yang trying to frontline now and comes back in, feeling confident with the bravado of Yang leading in onto Ice. Beast down onto the Cliques. Now they turn towards Old Chicken. The Octarine, the heals. Is it going to be enough? Lotus Orbs laid down onto him by Orlando. They try to keep him alive. Siphon, he's turning around. He's going to keep himself alive. The ghosts are going to come back into him. They can't kill this Death Prophet. They've killed 3 off. They can't seem to get anything more. They'll look to chase it. The Shiva's Guard holding them down. Old Chicken back up to full health with the Ghost Heal. His Igloo's put down. Mikasa's still jumping forward, trying to control them. The Siki Napalms, the Goo as well. Old Lana to pop. Old Chicken, where's your ghost now, honey bun? It's going to be a team wipe. VGR take them all down. A buyback from the Tusk comes out. But VGR, they're going to be the ones happy with that fight. Huge, huge gold swing and XP gain there. 5.4k difference created off the back of that fight.
That was massive.
I mean, it was so big. Yang just, what a beast. He just stood in the middle of it all and punched people.
Yeah, this is the problem with the Klinks against the Bristleback and the Lycan, is that during fights where the Klinks no longer has magic immunity, you just get ran at and you cannot stand still. Like, if you sit there and you auto-attack a Bristleback, he's probably going to win the trade. He has more armor than you. He has more health than you. Your damage output might be slightly higher, but it's not enough to justify sitting there and getting hit by a Lycan and a Bristleback simultaneously. And because of the fact that they didn't have Chrono when they initiated, there was just no control. Like, sure, dropping the spells in the void with no ultimate is not necessarily an ideal thing for VGR to do, but if they didn't know the Chrono was down, then that was the right play. And I'm assuming that they just thought it was up. And that's the impact of old 11 going into a fight before they're ready. Like, simply put, EHOME were not prepared to take that fight, and they went for it anyway.
Roshan's going to be back up very shortly as well. Just about 40 seconds until the Roche respawn. VGR, they're ready to fight without that.
Scan's going to hit here, so EHOME no. Hey.
Bibbidi bobbidi, they've found it out. VGR aren't going to be able to get away with anything too sneaky up on the high ground here. Oh. Here we go, Mikasa. Still going to try for a jump in. Ready to move in from the sidelines. Firefly into the trees. Keeping that high ground vision. Actually going to make a move towards bottom. They want to catch out the defender. And they've done it. Oh, Chicken grabbed out. Brought back Yang. Now starting to be down with the Sikine Palm. They need some more backup, but they're not going to get it. BKB comes out with the Death Prophet and EHOME. Moving over. They want to fight. They're looking for the control. The snowball, the punch onto Yang. But he pulls the BKB. Starts to run back. Static Storm trapping out all 11. They'll take down the faceless Void. And Yang ready to move in for more. Chasing them down. Forcing EHOME back to the base. The Glimpse bringing Old Chicken back. And trying to get the damage down. But False Promise keeps Old Chicken alive. He's going to just move in with the Crypt Swarm ready to fight. The mech Green. Pop turning into Old Chicken. He's going to pop low, but not low enough. He's kept alive. Buyback from the Void. Still has the Chronosphere available. Can he get himself into the fight? In comes the Chrono. He's got it. Holding on to it. Old 11. Who's he going to drop it on? He's eyeing up Yang. Does he want to commit it for the Bristle? No, he wants to find something else. In fact, Yang, he still wants to fight. Goes straight back in. Mikasa jumping in. Again, baiting out the snowball. It will pull them out to the sideline. Yang and the boys should be able to beat down onto the Tusk. Is there going to be any kind of save from the side? Fenrir trying to throw in the heels. The Lotus Orb's there as well. Lanham. He's going to be kept alive. Blinks out as well. He survives this. Old 11 still sneaking around with the Shadow Blade. He's still got that Chronosphere. They've got the Vision Link as his pod. Yang starting to turn his attention back towards the Void. Time walk away. The Bash is real, but the damage is not quite there. He's trapped up by the Igloo. Yang, he's still ready to go back in. He does not care at this point. They just can't kill him. BKB's already out from Eyesight Size. He's going to run out soon. Jumping in again. Time dilation. There's your Chrono. Finally onto Yang. But can they actually kill him? Siphon the damage. FI trying to go for the save, but it doesn't work. They've lost the Bristleback. Snowball across. They're going to be able to find themselves. The second, the beat down from Old Lanner with a Walrus Punch. They'll take down two, but the buyback's now coming out. Yang needs to get himself back to defend Roshan. Now this push from the mid lane. And indeed, EHOME winning a fight at the time that Roshan's back up into the game.
That fight was insane. If Old 11 didn't have buyback, that would have been a catastrophe for EHOME. They baited the fight for so long that Old Chicken's ultimate is 8 seconds off cooldown. That means that they had to have been fighting for almost 2 minutes straight for the ultimate to have dissipated and almost come up. That was just ridiculous. And you saw how much Old 11 is holding onto his Chrono. He knows how important it is, and how VGR are just fighting this engagement where they're all staying as far away as they possibly can from each other, because if two or three heroes get chronoed, it's just straight up over. Ice is going to lay into you with the damage that he has with the Deso, the crit, and the Diffusal Blade, and you're not going to be able to stand there anymore. But, you know, VGR, they managed to get away losing only a couple of heroes, forcing yet another buyback from the side of EHOME, but they need a way of fighting this Roche. They can't give it away. And the unfortunate part is EHOME doesn't have Chrono for another 30 seconds.
Might be short enough, though. VGR, I'm going to move straight over to the pit dash. With the smoke, they're going to look for a wraparound. See if they can find themselves a pick-off before kicking off the Roche attempt. Mikasa needs to lead the way. Needs to find the perfect initiation from the sidelines. Fire flying up. Still under the cover of the smoke, Mikasa is looking for an opening. What's he going to be able to find? Already Yang moving in, trying to get the vision for the side, but oh, the time dilation is going to force Mikasa to blink back, and now moving in. Static Storm's laid down, but already the BKB is coming out. Yang running around the side here. Chrono comes out from all 11, but it catches just End. On the side of the Crimson Guard is already out. They can't get the damage down on End. FI tethering across, keeping the Lycan alive, and now they'll turn in. Yang building up the Quill Spray stacks. EHOME starting to melt. Ice drops. They've lost the Tusk as well. Old 11, look at the bashes. Finds it. The new damage isn't going to be enough for Yang. No, falls to the sidelines. Yang survives. End turns around, gets the bash off. Old 11 jumps in and bashes it back. Takes down the Lycan. The Yules onto the Bristleback trying to set it up. Yang falling low. The Ghost around as well. Old 11 trying to find the kill onto DDC. Tether from FY keeping Yang alive. They'll back out the Bristleback from this fight. DDC has still got a lot of his hands on the sidelines. They've trapped him up in the trees. They will find the kill. They're not done yet though. Ice. Sneaky, sneaky. Hello, FY. Do you want to die? Diffusal Blade. Has he got a charge? Yes, he has. Goodbye, Ghost Scepter. Goodbye, Ball. IO taken down as well, EHOME.
No buybacks, this should be Rush for EHOME.
Absolutely, three convincing kills.
Oh my god, they're just committing buybacks to every single fight because they know that they have to win the 5v5. Without it, they can't get Roshan. Without Roshan, they can't go base. They absolutely needed to win that fight, and EHOME walk away with a victory, with a cheese, with an Aegis. Now VGR are feeling themselves backed up against the wall here.
Let's have a look at the buyback status. At the moment...
I mean, the Disruptor just got his buyback, but yeah. He did not have it during the engagement itself.
I mean, if VGR can take down that Klinks, you know, this is 5.5 minutes that Ice doesn't have buyback available, and we know they're pushing past you.
Oh, I think that it's actually very hard for EHOME to take a straight-up teamfight, even with Chrono and Death Prophet Ultimate available. Like, keep in mind, if Ice doesn't have buyback, EHOME get crushed there. Like, they don't have to ever run away if you're VGR worrying about the Klinks coming back into the teamfight and just dealing that bonus damage, but... Just the fear of the buyback, I think, is what makes VGR kind of have to start abandoning fighting that and then eventually just lose the Roche. But you could also just commend EHOME for planning ahead, realizing that they're going to need buyback on their cores to ensure that they can get the objective after the fight's over. Because sometimes you're just too low on health and mana to even kill Roshan. So I think that it's just very, very good team play and coordination here from EHOME, keeping themselves in the game. And while the rest of VGR respawn, kind of reset here to ground zero, Scan's going to scout out. Couple of members at EHOME walking through their own woods, and we'll see where the next fight's going to take place.
Let's see what happens. Mikasa goes for a D ward, needs to be a little bit careful. They are in the neighborhood, and they are smoked up as well at EHOME. See what they can get done here. All ults available. Old Chicken and Ice leading the way close behind them, though. Old 11 is there. Ready with the Chronosphere. Cheese as well to hand for this Faceless Void. But VGR, they're respecting the fact that they're off the map. They're already back up in the base. Yang stands guard by the entrance to their home. And EHOME, they're not going to want to go in for the dive.
It's super scary to fight. Like, knowing this time around that you don't have buybacks, and you're very, very far away from your base, even if you did. Like, realistically, no one would be able to get there in time unless they had bots. Which I'm pretty sure, yep, no one has it. So, their base is being pushed in. I don't know if VGR really want to go super aggressive here. It's very, very scary at this stage in the game. You know, you lose one or two more engagements against the Klinks and how much farm he has, the Death Prophet Ultimate, you lose your base just incredibly fast. And we could be seeing a very quick game 5 if EHOME take one more successful engagement.
Absolutely, I mean, 33-33. This game... could not feel any closer. But the recent way the fights are going, you definitely, yeah, indeed. From the XP leading the net worth lead, you have to favor EHOME, I feel, at this point of the game. But there's definitely potential for VGR to outplay them with the tools that they've got.
Yeah, for sure.
They've just got to be smart about it.
They really need the... The biggest issue they're having is there's two melee cores, and the two melee cores both want to stick on the same target. You both really want to go on the Klink, so Ice doesn't have any freedom to just sit there and auto-attack people. But the problem with that is that if you're both on top of each other, you get chronoed. And if you get chronoed, you're dead. So it's a rough situation, to say the least. EHOME now walking down bottom lane looking to siege.
Alright.
This is the make or break here for VGR. Even if EHOME fail this push, they will have other chances.
And we're going to keep eyes on the top. N going for the split.
We've seen this movie before.
Yeah, EHOME already back in responding to that. They say, alright, we're not letting this happen. They lost the tier 2 top. Necro units will still continue to do a little bit maybe to the tier 3, as if indeed N sends them in. It looks like he will. Standing down a bit of damage. Old Lanham's going to come in for the cleanup. Just to stop the push, but as we can see, just this one man's movement, this one like and push, enough to rumble the jimmies, rustle the jimmies of the whole team and force them back to react to it.
It's a good thing as well. The longer you wait, the less likely EHOME will have the Aegis up for the push. And sure, you still have to worry about the cheese, but that's not really... quite as scary. We are seeing Mikasa get more farmed here. He's got the BKB now on top of the Shivas, the Blink, the Force Staff, the Yules. His inventory is more or less full. At this point, he can't really get any stronger than he already is, unless he buys like bots to a refresher and puts it in the stash.
Still waiting to see Yang spend his money. It's 4.6k on top of that ultimate orb. I mean, what are we looking at here? Skadi? Hex? What's the plan?
I'm actually kind of thinking Hex is really good because against the Faceless Void,
yeah,
and against the Klink, since there's a 5-second BKB. Or sorry, it's actually 7 seconds. How is Ice Ice only BKB'd 3 times in a 50-minute game? That actually sounds insane to me. But either way, it's strong because the way that the teamfights have been going for VGR when they're winning is when Old 11 gets caught up by a Static Storm, and he dies before he's able to get Chrono, or Chrono's just on cooldown. So I think that's like the number one priority. If they can hex him and kill him before he's able to ult, I think they would do, you know, it would do a lot.
Now we are seeing the Aegis timeout. Of course, Ice was the man to carry it, so that's now gone.
Oh, it's a Scotty. Okay.
All right. Okay.
Burning, I mean, Scotty is very useful for being able to stick on targets.
That's true. And especially the way that Yang's been playing. You know, he's not been fiddling around in these fights. He's straight in there with the right clicks.
Yep. So I mean, it obviously makes him a more durable target as well. Whereas Hex is more of like a... You need to coordinate properly and kill the proper hero. It's like this is I'm going to be tanky. If I hit the clinks, even if he pops BKB, I can still chase him down. I have the SNY and the Scotty, so like the slow between those two is like ridiculous. Like the SNY slow is 26%, and then the Scotty slow is 35, so you're pretty much never going to get kited if you hit somebody with that.
Talking about Hexes, our chicken's now got his finish. So it's a little bit harder for this big bag, especially with the fact that End hasn't got that BKB. And, of course, you look at the lineup, there's no Lotus Orbs out as well, so... I mean, should they need to do something with regards to the Lycan and the fact that DP's got a Hex? Like, whether it be BKB for him, or whether it be DDC or FY picking up a Lotus Orb.
I would like to see a Lotus on somebody, yeah. But I don't think DDC is going to be able to afford it. Maybe FY? He's been getting a lot more of the farm on the team. Like, he's got 4,000 net worth over the Disruptor right now, so... The other thing is, I really think the Disruptor wants a Ghost Scepter, because the Clinks and the Death Prophet ultimate still do a fair amount of damage to him. I mean, poor DDC just dies in a fight in like 1 second if he gets attacked by the Clinks. Now, granted, he does have a Diffusal Blade upgrade now, so he's got 8 more charges on the Purge, but, you know, forcing him to use it is still okay. Like, just him just killing you with 2 auto attacks is less okay.
Yeah, looking at the Lycan as well, it really feels like with the gold that he's mounted to, he's... Okay, so it's not going to be a BKB for himself. He is sending the courier out to the secret shop. What does he get with this money?
Abyssal.
Oh, he's picked up a VIP booster.
Yeah, he's going Abyssal. Okay. He has a battery.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
Finished off the Vanguard. Okay, even to the fight, he's going to get the start off. Lotus Orbs coming out. Yang, the one on the front at the moment, taking a few bashes. As you can see, he's quite a brute to bring down. Now the Ghost and the Shiva's Guard come out. Yang's put the BKB, still trying to slow down old Chicken. If anything, just create space for the rest of his team to back out and find themselves in a better position to fight Yang. He may be sacrificed for this one, though. Shiva's Hex coming out.
Oh, God.
Chrono from all 11 onto 2. DDC caught out Mikasa. Looks like he's out of the Chrono, but apparently he's in it. The tail got caught. DDC buys back on the Disruptor, realizing he needs to get himself back in the fight. Mikasa pulls the BKB, but it doesn't matter. They've taken down the bat. Dead for 90 seconds now. This is a scary bit of the game for VGR.
FY is dead too.
Oh, man.
That should be almost game, actually. Two heroes dead for about 70 seconds.
It's not looking good for them. Yeah, they could go straight in for the big old push.
They can just throw them. They don't even have to. They don't know that VGR don't have buybacks, but if they did, they would just be hitting tier 4s right now.
That's true. The only reason they don't have buybacks as well is because they went all in with the purchases. Yeah. They just don't have the dollar. Yang, still going to be relatively annoying on this run line. But yeah, at least they're going to get the second set of racks down, and it just depends on if you home do feel confident enough to try and move in and take more. Yang, controlled out, blocked up on the igloo. They're going to try for mega creeps here. E-Home, heading towards the top. Okay, here we have the fight, and coming out, immediately controlled by the Yules. Fenrir in trouble. Okay, into the snowball he goes. He's going to be fine. And looking to focus on, drops the stun down onto Ice. Shang with the BKB still moving forward, but oh, he got hit by a Silver Edge. Bristleback's gone. He does have buyback and he's going to need to use it. They are going to have the full lineup back up in a minute, but maybe not before the mega creeps are taken. 11 Chrono back and available in 10 seconds and trying to chop into the void, but he just can't do it. This is looking like They're nearing at the end, unless they can find Ice. The Bash is there. Ice. Oh, he finds the rest, but he's dead. Does have buyback available. The Chrono coming out onto three. The Ghost around as well. VGR, they need a bit of a miracle to turn this one around. Lasso onto old Lanham, controlling himself. He's lassoed himself. He's going to pull forward, chasing down old Lemon, getting the Firefly down over them all. But Yang, focused up, being bashed out by old Lemon. They'll jump forward. The Hex onto him. Old Lanham, can they even bring down this Tusk? The stun's there. Ed will find the kill. Three dead at the moment on him. And now old Lemon, time walking out. Mikasa jumping forward, slowing him up. The stacks build up. Elite the cheese. Is it going to be enough to keep him alive? They're still chasing. They don't want to let this Void get out alive. There's the Abyssal Blade drop down. The damage is there. Old 11 taken down as well. And VGR, they do find the kills, but the base is already in shambles.
They need to all in. The only way they win this game is if they all in. They force all the buybacks from eHome, and then they win a fight inside of eHome's base. That is the only condition for victory right now.
All right, well, observers for everyone.
Yeah. I mean, this is the last ditch effort here from VGR. If they go down mid and they lose the fight, the game is over.
I'm going to say that everything has got to be put to this push. Everything. Bots picked up by end. They know that they've got to do this. This is the be-all, end-all for VGR. eHome do have buybacks, and they will be willing to use them. Yang already cleaning out the wave on the bottom, trying to find that opening. There's a tier 2 mid, so they've got to go for the tier 4s. The pings are out. The game plan is set for VGR.
If they do this, it would be insane. Like, they have everything except for relocate. Oh, that's the only thing they're missing.
There's no BKB still on this lock, and it really feels like an issue. Okay, Yang starting to go for this. Chipping away. Exorcism is going to be back up in 10, and immediately Necrobook's out. Tier 4 starting to fall. The push starting off to a good start. Fortification comes through. Mikasa, we can see if he can pick anyone up. Flying around, grabs Old Chicken, but immediately the false promise to save the Death Prophet. He's going to be fine. Cryptstorm's Blam coming through. They're moving in for more. Sporadic Storm on the middle of it all. Catches out Old 11. Old Lanham and Old 11. Old 11 pops the BKB and still trying to frontline the Abyssal, but the Chrono's fit. Controlling the wolf, they've already lost DDC on the disruptor. Old 11 beating down to the end. FY with a defensive relocate, keeping him alive. They'll turn their attention towards Yang. Yang's left to Leon, and Yang's taken down. GG is called. eHome have done it here. They've brought this series in the grand finals of the Chinese regionals for TI6 to a game 5. What a game indeed, and what a fight from both sides. Back and forward, back and forward, but that last final victorious fight for eHome, really cementing the game. VGR tried to give it their all at the end. There was a little glimmer of hope, but at the end of the day, eHome, they were just far too far ahead.
Well, I think we learned a valuable lesson here today. You ban Drill Ranger, and eHome wins.
That seems to be the way.
That is pretty much exactly how this series has gone.
That is the pattern that we're seeing this series.
Two games, VG get Drill, they win. Two games they don't get it, they lose. So I'm guessing it's going to be more of the same here in game number 5. But excellent performance from both teams. It's just that eHome, they managed to take a couple of fights in key situations where they were able to secure Roshan, obviously getting the cheese on their side as well. Old 11's build in the Void was perfect for the game. He knew what he needed. He just needed the Lincolns to protect some of his core heroes. The Silver Edge against the Bristleback proved to like delete Yang from the game. Like how
yeah,
fast
the Silver Edge
he
was
died.
Great pickup.
Like he just got obliterated. So the fights, VGR needed to be maybe a little bit more proactive around the map and trying to find engagements with the Lycan Wolves and abusing Relocate with the Batrider and whatnot. But unfortunately, on the back of a couple of clutch team fights from eHome, they were able to secure too much of a lead, and VGR just simply couldn't hold.
They simply couldn't indeed. Well, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. Game 5 will be right around the corner. Hello, eHome versus VGR. I'm sure you guys won't go anywhere, as it's been quite a series so far. Me and Andy will be with you in a momentum. See you in a bit.